Hello everyone, it's Galina and thank you for joining me. Today I'm going to show you how to create a festive card using your regular supplies. I'm going to use this cupcake shaker die, which normally I will use for birthday cards, but during a holiday season I associate it with a festive bakery. So I ran this die through my die cutting machine 2 times with gold mirrored cardstock and red glitter paper. And I got a lot of small pieces that can be used all at once, and I can mix and match them. And for today's card, I'm going to use 2 outlined frames with some red pieces inside. At first, I'm going to attach my outline frames on my base. I'm using a piece of vellum. I'm applying a small amount of liquid glue on my die cut pieces because I don't want to warp my vellum. Attach both these outline frames and then I'm going to inlay my red glitter pieces. And again, I'm using just teeny tiny amount of liquid glue. In this way, I'm going to create a cherry cream on the top of my cupcake. And the bottom part of my cupcake I'm going to leave as is because there will be a shaker. But before making a shaker, I need to stamp a sentiment for my card. I'm going to heat emboss a holiday cheer sentiment directly on this vellum piece. I'm going to use a small sentiment from Happy Public Day stamp set and I'm stamping it with Versamark clear ink. I'm covering up the sentiment with fine detailed white embossing powder and I'm going to melt it with my preheated heat gun. And I'm using my heat gun just for a couple of seconds because it's super hot. I can melt my powder fast and do not warp the vellum. And now I can trim out the excess vellum piece with my scissors. And also you can leave a thin frame around the gold cupcake. On the back side of my cupcake, I'm going to apply a dark brown distress ink just to change the color of the cake to more realistic. Next, I cut out a small panel for my cake using a medium die from Darling Ribbon die set from Studio Katya, and I cut it out from a green cardstock. To create a shaker base using my cupcake die cut, I'm going to place a few foam tape stripes on the back side of my die cut. I picked 2 different embellishments to put inside of my shaker, and at first I'm going to add these beautiful gold seed beads. I have a small shaker base, so I don't need them much. And then I'm going to add just a small amount of these beautiful shiny 3mm sequins. I'm removing a baking paper from my shaker base and I'm covering up all these beautiful embellishments with my cupcake die cut. Next, I cut out a red card panel for my card using a largest die from the Darling Ribbons die set from Studio Katya. I'm going to foam mount my shaker base on this red card panel. And to embellish my card, I'm going to use these beautiful shiny red pearls. Actually, the whole idea of this card came out from these beautiful embellishments. And I love to find inspiration in my craft supplies. So I add them a lot, really. And I attach all of them using liquid glue from Studio Katya. It dries transparently and will hold well all the embellishments. And also I used my embellishment pen to pick up those beautiful pearls. At last moment I decided to add a shiny bow on the top of my card, so I removed 1 big pearl on the card to have a place to put this beautiful glitter die cut. I cut it out using a 3rd die from Darling Ribbon die set. And here is my finished card. It's super festive, shiny, and I really love this little shaker inside of my cupcake die cut. Don't forget to check out the blog for more information and inspiration. Find all the links below this video as well as in the comments. Please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe for more inspirational videos. And I will see you soon. Bye!